Welcome back to Eat, Play, Stay. Now, where were we? Let's see. We've dined at the Nerd's Table, we've conquered the beer and ale trail, and I promised to give you some space. Ah, yes, space, the final frontier. And what better place for the non-astronaut to experience it than the Space Center? These are the voyages of Eat, Play, Stay, our continuing mission to find you exotic places not too far away. On March 17th of 1970, the U.S. Space and Rocket Center opened their doors to the public for a missile defense technology and space exploration showcase, establishing Huntsville as Rocket Center USA. The Rocket Center is perhaps what Huntsville is best known for, and it does not disappoint.
The significance of what we are at the U.S. Space and Rocket Center is a beacon for the hopes and dreams of space exploration. Space Camp is a very immersive, hands-on learning experience to be an astronaut for a week, where you get to see what it's like to live and work in space, eat like an astronaut, learn like an astronaut.
The Space Camp started in the summer of 1982 and is world-renowned. Some who have passed through the program have gone on to become astronauts. In fact, there are a few from the program who are part of the current astronaut corps.
You are those next scientists, astronauts, engineers, and explorers that will pave the way for our future discoveries. We have simulators that allow you to feel a second or two of weightlessness. In order to experience the Rocket Center a little bit deeper, and that's pun intended, we do have an underwater training experience where you can suit up and dive and become and train like an astronaut does.
We also have Moonshot, which stimulates a launch into space, and so you literally experience some G-force coming up out of your seat. Everything's science-based, but it's also just a lot of fun. The Saturn V Hall with the National Historic Landmark Saturn V rocket is always a highlight.
On loan from the Smithsonian Institute, the Saturn V rocket is actually the largest piece in the entire Smithsonian collection. No surprise there. The rocket is 360 feet tall. That is even taller than the Statue of Liberty.
I think my favorite part about the Space Center is the fact that they have a huge Saturn V rocket.
You can see like the different parts of the engine and the big thruster things at the back.
Also at the other side of that hall, we have the Apollo 16 capsule that actually went to the moon. Look inside that capsule, see how tiny that space was, and imagine a four-day trip to the moon and back in that.
It's just the history that's here. Things that I grew up with watching, and like toys that I grew up with, and being raised in the 80s when like the 80s space exploration was going on, and just being able to now bring my kids to this place and see all the stuff that I loved when I was a kid. I think there's something here for everybody, but if you have kids, it's a great place too, because they have like lots of tactile things and things you can get in and things you can look at.
Probably my favorite part is number one, that I get to come with my family and that they get to see it too.
My favorite part about the Space Center is the planetarium. And they have this awesome technology to really take you out of this world. It's crazy cool. I think it's super important for folks to come out and see the U.S. Space and Rocket Center, especially kids. They really can start a pathway. You never know what being curious around these halls might lead to the next astronaut going into space.
Consider the journey of the astronaut, the celestial traveler who makes it their life's mission to float into the ether of space, into the formless void that has haunted and intrigued citizens of Earth for millennia. It makes me feel inspired. It makes me feel humbled. But above all, it makes me want to create something beautiful.